It was early springtime and the strike was on. It drove us miners out of doors, out from the houses that the company owned. We moved into tents up at old Ludlow. I was worried bad about my children, soldiers guarding the railroad bridge. Every once in a while a bullet would fly, kick up gravel under my feet. We were so afraid you'd kill our children.
If anybody is listening to this, be certain, because we are denouncing the crimes of ex-president Gonzalo Sanchez de Lozada. Gonzalo Sanchez de Lozada must be brought to trial, must be brought to justice.
Juicio para Goni, no más impunidad. Juicio para Goni, no más impunidad. Juicio para Goni, no más impunidad.
Sanchez de Lozada is responsible not only for the killing of nearly 60 people in this event many years ago, he is also responsible with the suffering of hundreds of the families. We are outraged by the fact that the United States is harboring criminals by allowing him to live comfortably right here in the United States. Gonzalo Sanchez de Lozada must be brought to trial, must be brought to justice in his own country. He is now with an order of extradition from Bolivia. However, the United States is not honoring that extradition, even though there is a treaty between both countries for this kind of situations.
It's just political persecution, because they need a boogeyman. They need somebody to blame for a coup to a constitutionally elected president. And it's very clear what happened, and, you know.
What happened?
No, I won't say it, because it has to be clarified. But I can just tell you that it has no rhyme or reason, and so that you won't be frustrated by my answer.
I think that behind the movement that overthrew Goni, there was this income distribution issue. An income distribution, we can judge the problems of income distribution in terms of justice. That's, of course, well taken, and I admit, but also in terms of political stability. Suddenly, the societies became not more unequal than they were before. Where Bolivia was always an unequal society, but it became a lot more an unequal society.
What was all the problem with me? I wanted to do a pipeline through Chile, sell the petroleum to the U.S. and to Mexico, liquid natural gas, and take all the income from that and put it into a fund for health and education. Mm-hmm. But this was terrible. You can't go through Chile, and we're against Chile, although. Mm-hmm. But the IMF said you can't take any more debt down if it's not concessional. But at the same time, they gave us the forgiveness, they closed the concessional door. So we couldn't borrow him, and yeah. They asked for things which were unreasonable. And unfortunately, it's not their fault, because if you do it, you do it. And you know, when you have these problems, the worst thing you can do is blame somebody else. Then the next worst thing you can do is blame yourself. So then what you do is you sort of live with it, and you find out usually you're more on faulty than the others, because you shouldn't have been out there in a perfect storm. Mm-hmm. And if you were in a perfect storm, you should have known how to bring the boat back. Sometimes there's good captains, sometimes they're not. And sometimes bad guys win. But what are you going to do? That's life. Nobody obliged me to be the president. There's one recommendation I can make to all of you. If they offer you the presidency, you're going to turn it down. And I hope that you, I won't ask back for your honorary doctor's degree.
Not at all.
And I hope
I look forward to reading this book.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's great to see you, and I'm delighted to see you well.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good, thank you.
We definitely, or at least I personally, don't believe that the Harvard Business School is not aware of what is going on with this fellow. What is surprising to me, though, is that they have invited him to speak anyway. And, well, what we did right here, basically, is to try to make evident that not everybody is completely ignorant about the crimes of this gentleman.
Where you killed these 13 children inside. I said, God bless the mine workers union. Then I hung my head and cried.
As a good Catholic, I know the best you can do is say you're sorry.